in your body, in your mind. That's why the enemy fights you in your mind. The devil doesn't have to tie you up for you to be bound. He just has to tie up your head. With stress, with worry, with aggravation, with low self-esteem, with pettiness, with anger, with hostility, with rebellion. And he can make you physically sick because your mind is sick. Lay your hands on your head and say, give me a new mind. Give me a new mind means give me a new perspective. Give me a new perspective. Give me a new way of looking at my situation. Give me a new way of looking at my circumstances. Get my mind ready for this year, because when I get this year, there's going to be blessings. There's going to be miracles. There's going to be opportunities. Oh, yes, it's going to be some struggles. It's going to be some challenges. It's going to be some tests. But even the struggles are an opportunity for me to show off the victory if my mind can handle the change.
If you can take it, you can make it. If you can take it, you can make it. All right, you train, you fight way harder than those other guys, and you win. You get out from under. If you can take it, you can make it. You can do this. Just gotta believe you can.
There's some things I'm not taking with me in the new year. Everything that's inflexible and everything that's not ready and everything that's backwards and everything that's negative and everything that's condescending and everything that's carnal and everything that's holding me back, I refuse to take it over into another year and waste another new year with an old mind. Shape yourself around the comings and goings of this world. Don't shape your opinions and your attitudes around circumstances that you cannot change. If you go into another year and waste another year with the old mentality while somebody's in the hospital begging God for the opportunity that you have right now, you better step into this moment. As soon as you decide to stop looking for answers in other people and miracles somewhere down the yellow brick road and click the heel to your mind, you could have been free years ago. If you can get your mind out, you can get your money out, you can get your family out, you can get your job out, you can get your career out. You can get your health out. You can get your prosperity out. If you can get your mind out, no devil in hell, no weapon formed against you, no enemy that hates you, no witch that hexes you can stop you from being free. If you can get your mind out, grab yourself by the head and say, we're coming out of there. Tell them I'm coming out head first.
To your life has not been written yet, and it doesn't matter about what happened yesterday. It doesn't matter about what happens to you. What matters is, what are you going to do about it?
This year I will make this goal become a reality. I won't talk about it anymore. I can.
Get right now every book I can write. Some of you, after this, there may not be another opportunity. Let me tell you what I tell athletes. The worst thing in the world is not growing up in poverty. The worst thing in the world is growing up in poverty and coming here and get worship and not taking advantage of this, and you gotta go back to the hood. That's the worst thing that could ever happen to a bro. Traveling and being in hotels and seeing the world and eating like you eating and not taking advantage of this and getting kicked out and going back home to the hood. Being somebody that they talk about because you were sweet for 4 years. You better not lose this. This is an opportunity of a lifetime. Your grandma counting on you to do the right thing. Your mama counting on you. Your cousins, your brothers and sisters are counting on you to cash in on this opportunity.
Let's see.